In a remote and barren mountain range in Oman, Joe and Cody search low and high for signs of water.
Where I'm trying to get to is that thing.
While Joe is climbing towards a vantage point, the rock suddenly crumbles beneath his feet.
Oh, yeah. It rattled me pretty hard, but I was doing the right thing. I had two good handholds. I knew I was going to be okay.
Okay.
There we go.
Wow. This canyon that we've been following down, just dog legs back and forth and back and forth.
All I see in 360 degrees is nothing but more rock and more sand. That's a pretty big kick in the nuts.
You know, it was not easy getting up here, but it's that risk reward. At least I know now what Cody and I have to face as we move forward, and it's pretty ugly.
Walking up on this high ground is not the answer. We've got to stay in the canyon, a little bit easier walking, and if we get lucky, we may find some water.
Cody! I'm coming back!
I'm gonna link back up with Cody, and I hope he's got better news for me than what I'm about to tell him.
All right, here's the deal. I made it to this tower. I can see 360 degrees around. I saw where we came from. I can see where we're going. Nothing.
Okay.
What I will tell you is walking up there is a no-go.
So it's not quite the zenith. It's still a little bit cool. I think we should keep going down the canyon.
Agreed. It's the only option we have.
It's starting to get hot down in this canyon. So right now I'm looking for a better shelter because we're gonna be here for a while. I would rather not drink non-disinfected water. So my idea is to build a fire so we can take this stainless steel bottle and use it like a pot to bring it up to a boil or pasteurize it so it's safe to drink. This is a perfect little cave. We've seen those pictographs over there of people riding camels. You can see all the carbon in here. So this has been used for quite some time. It's deep enough back in there to where we're gonna get shade whenever we want it, regardless of the angle of the sun. It's out of the drainage enough where there's no flash flood danger. And I can do my fire out here where it doesn't smoke us out. And I think that's gonna work well.
Cody and I must find water. You will not survive in a desert situation like this without it. Cody, look, that is a beautiful sight.
Oh, man. When Joe finally sees the pool of water, it's like hallelujah. It's a huge score.
We may be able to get down, but getting up may be a little bit different, so just hold on a second.
It's totally vertical over here.
Yep, and over there, there's actually an overhang. We've got to figure out a way to get some water.
Well, if you get down there and you can't get back up, that kind of defeats the point.
Yeah, exactly.
So that's not an option for us to do.
We need the water, but the risk of me climbing down there is too much. Let's find some shade and think about what the hell we're gonna do here, dude.
When you find water in the desert, you make it as safe to drink as you possibly can, and you're gonna drink it, because if you don't, you're gonna die. We're gonna take all this blue cordage, take pieces of the blanket, tie it together, and we'll lower that down in there. My goal is not to cannibalize these blankets any more than we have to.
Gotcha.
But if we have to rip a whole blanket up to get that water, then that's what we have to
do. Done deal, okay.
If you're willing to do that, I'm gonna take those binoculars and I'm gonna try to get a fire going so that when you get that water out, we can disinfect it.
Although these blankets have provided Cody and I shelter, sometimes in a survival situation, you may have to destroy an asset to get the primary goal, and that's water.
That's what I don't want you to do.
This thing's so damn slick. You could actually taste the water. It is so close to you. But in a situation like this, stay focused and keep your head in the game. Build this thing, make it the right way, then use it.
The last thing Cody and I need is for this thing to go in the water. So I made a little loop here in the top to hold it, and then I've crisscrossed the bottom of it the best I can. But if I throw it in the water, I don't know if it's gonna sink. So I'm thinking about putting a rock or two in here just to get it some weight. There's a lot that can go wrong with this. We only have one can. So losing this can is not an option. Not sinking, which is not good. I'm really shocked because I put four decent sized rocks in there and it's still floating. It's still floating. Come on. Oh, yeah. There we go. It finally sinks below the water line and I see bubbles. Very happy. As I'm pulling this container up, it gets snagged on the rock below me. It's wet and it's heavy. It's only gonna take one little slip and out this thing comes.
Come on, you thing. Don't do this to me now.
Oh yeah. That is what I am talking about right there. This is a game changer for Cody and I. Game changer.
Here's a piece of camel poop. And it's just compressed cellulose and lignin, the main components of wood products. So essentially, it's like a fuel tablet. So the Bedouin use this all the time, and they'd fuel their fires up with this. I'm gonna powder it down so I can have the pieces small enough to literally ignite and burn like an ember. I'm creating some surface area on this nice warm rock, and we'll get this all nice and dry. The more surface area you can get on this, the better.
For centuries, the Bedouin have collected camel dung to use as an easily ignited fuel for fire.
One of these lenses on this binocular is basically a magnifying glass. So I'm gonna get some bright sun, and here's my ignition source.
Fussy. Damn it. There goes the sun again, here it comes again.
We have intermittent clouds in the picture, and if you have cloud cover that blocks the sun, you're not going to make fire. So now it's a waiting game in the shade. It's a real tease.
Still just diffused a little bit. I'm going to try to make it work.
If I don't have sun, I can't light this fire. And we need to light this fire to disinfect that water. Did you get water?
Yeah, man.
When Joe comes back, I still don't have a fire. It's mildly embarrassing. But if I don't have sun, I can't do it. There's still a bunch of clouds, but there's pockets.
How long have you been trying for?
10, 15 minutes.
Without fire, we cannot disinfect this water. We got wide open sun right now, dude.
It's diffused sun. I'm getting a little bit of smoke.
Several years back, I was in a situation where I had to drink some water out of a stream, and it looked clean. I spent 2 weeks in the hospital and almost died from it.
Come on. There we go. There we go.
Here it comes.
Damn it. There goes the sun again.
Cody, look.
Joe and Cody have finally found a source of water in the Oman Desert.
There we go.
But because of intermittent cloud cover, Cody struggles to start a fire to make the water safe for drinking.
If ever there was a time Cody and I needed fire, it's right now. Water is everything right now, and I really don't feel like drinking water.
Come on. There we go. There we go.
If you did get sick out here from drinking bad water, you do risk dying because you dehydrate from the inside out with diarrhea. Here it comes.
Finally, Cody gets a break, he gets an ember, he's got a fire going. That is great. All we're gonna do from this point forward is to drink water and super hydrate.
This round's ready, so I'm gonna pull it off. I'm gonna let it cool.
Cody and I are not going anywhere right now. We are gonna drink water and we're gonna eat a little bit and we're gonna rest and recharge our batteries.
Rehydrating requires more than just water. The body also requires electrolytes. After a period of dehydration, a person who consumes only water can enter a state of hyponatremia, or water intoxication, that causes muscle cramps, nausea, and in extreme cases, death.
Here, just sample. What do you think? Is it done? Tastes like chicken?
No. But calories are calories right now.
For anyone in this situation, having water to drink, having something to eat, and having a place to bed down at night is a grand slam home run.
Care how much you can live off the land out here. Unless you plan on marrying and having kids wearing loincloths and eating more lizards for several centuries, you're going to walk to rescue or hope someone gets you out of the scenario.
It's getting real green.
I hear water.
I do too. Where in the hell is it at?
Look at that.
As we walk out of this canyon, we see a spot where water is literally coming out of the side of the canyon wall. No brainer, follow this out.
Perennial water, for now.
Yeah.
I've seen these things disappear in the ground before.
All right.
But for now, we're good. That's awesome.
Survival protocol says follow water out, and that's exactly what we're gonna do. We're gonna follow this water for as far as we can and hopefully come across somebody or civilization. This canyon is getting very narrow, literally as wide as our arms are apart. So we're gonna jump in the water and wade through this stuff, and I'll tell you what, it's gonna feel great.
This almost seems like a really mean illusion that all of a sudden we're literally over our head in water with abundance. And I'm thinking in the back of my head, how long is this gonna really last? Where there's water, there's people.
So much for the water, Cody.
I know.
This is gone.
It's almost tempting to turn back. It's not an option. Look at that thing. See that rock wall right there?
That looks man-made to me, Cody.
It is man-made. Might be 1,000 years ago, but
yeah,
it's man-made.
Yeah, no doubt. Let's keep going.
As you reach the end of this wadi, into this flat valley, I see a ruin. So is it a civilization that was here 1,000 years ago? Or is there a town right around the corner? We don't know.
Cody, come here.
Oh my God.
Those are buildings.
Yeah, it's a whole town. Wow.
Yep.
When we round the corner, there it is. There's an entire town right there in view. As beautiful as the Arabian Desert is, it's still a killer. The most common ways to die out here are hyperthermia and dehydration. So always leave a game plan before you travel and always carry your water.
The deserts of the Middle East are brutal environments. They do not allow for too many mistakes. But at the end of the day, mental and physical toughness is what's going to get you out of here alive.
Yeah,